All right, all right. Your turn. What have you got for us?
Okay, so you've all probably heard of the Battle of Seufz. But do you know what really happened? Outside an old sepulcher, the only sounds were the wind, the shifting grass, and a snarl. An autophage wearing the mask of a monk hummed and growled at the mystery it had found. But then another sound. Footsteps. Minerva and a troop from the Sterling City stepped forth, spears ready. The monster grinned as it reached out with its maw and its mind, raising Minerva's comrades and summoning its own. But Minerva had hope. Her fists filled with light, she shouted, she charged, and...
Oh no, you've got it all wrong. The autophage wasn't like that. It had a big flowy mane and a giant mouth in its stomach, and the village hero was just a lowly squire. Shekmati found the beast at the heart of town, surrounded by common folk. But just as he attacked, an old devoted monk stopped him. "Don't worry," he said. "Look." And suddenly, the autophage pulled a fiddle from his fur and started to play, the villagers joining in song and dance as...
Oh! Well, I hope you're all ready, because there wasn't an autophage or a knight at all. It was Bibu Bubo and Maul. No, it was Rayla Redgale in the Chimera. Wait, no. Oh, it was Ire and the Muse. Yeah, this whole thing was Kali's story that she called in this huge dragon beetle, and then she blasted Kali with lightning, and it was awesome. But since Kali was getting beaten so bad, she got all the Grail Home witnesses to shoot the dragon beetle into space. But then Ire was like, "Ha ha ha, you fool," and started glowing like the sun before she exploded everything in the forest. But then a bunch of super smart Grail Home made this big boat for Kali with a big spooky Ire piloting it. And in the boat was another boat. And inside that was a third boat. And in the third boat was a fourth boat. And it was on fire!
So what about you? What's your story then?